Sydney's lockdown has been extended for another 2 weeks after the state recorded another 97 locally acquired cases. 20 patients are in intensive care, including 53-year-old John, who's shown here on a ventilator at St Vincent's Hospital. And while the video is confronting to watch, it is something that doctors want all Australians to see. It's not an ad, it's a real person there. The release of the video comes as health authorities in Victoria race to control two separate clusters of COVID-19, which have both stemmed from New South Wales. 11 new cases were reported yesterday, with the MCG listed as an exposure site. Masks will now be mandatory in the state in all indoor settings apart from at home, and a three-day lockdown is being considered. Joining me now is epidemiologist at Monash University, Professor James Trauer. Morning to you. Let's start with that situation in Morning, Victoria. Matt. Is a snap lockdown inevitable?
Well, I think it seems very likely. We've seen increasing cases over the last few days, more exposure sites every day. And I think we know that if we go early with lockdowns, the earlier we go, the shorter they need to be. And so we need to get on top of this. And we still don't really understand the scale of the number of cases that are being created at the moment. So I would really support an early lockdown.
So when would that be announced? Because, as you said, they've got to go early. Will they wait till today's numbers go in? Will it set in over the weekend?
Well, I'm not part of the decisions, unfortunately. I think it would be appropriate to. I think it could certainly be considered today. I was very glad to see that masks are being mandated indoors. That's a very sensible thing to do first up. And then lockdown measures are logical to follow after that. I think considering that today is very reasonable. Often it's announced in the morning, so we'll wait to see what happens later this morning from the politicians.
This decision that masks are compulsory indoor and outside, that was only made about midnight last night. They must be pretty concerned in Victoria.
Yes, but it's also a very logical first thing to do. It's much more reasonable to ask people to wear masks universally, particularly inside, than ask people to close businesses. So we really need to mandate masks broadly very early in any response and come to lockdown measures next.
OK, there's been some modelling done that shows Sydney's current restrictions could last for months until these vaccination rates get high enough to bring down the cases. How long do you think it's going to take to get this outbreak in Sydney under control?
Well, I agree with what other epidemiologists have suggested, people like Tony Blakely, who have suggested that we go really hard in Sydney, lock down to try to drive the reproduction number well below one. So the number of people being infected by each index case is well below one. And then we could get back down towards zero cases as quickly as possible. Try to do that within a few weeks and then release again. That's really what's been effective in the Australian COVID response over the last several months.
So what is hard? Does that mean shutting all the big stores?
I think so. I mean, I think something more akin to what we saw in stage four in Victoria last year, that's beyond what New South Wales are doing at the moment. And I think there's scope to do considerably more. But I think we need to understand what the purpose of that is. The reason to do that is to drive right back down to zero. Because once you get to zero, if there's no community cases at all, then you can release and get much closer back to normal and allow people to go about their daily lives again.
OK, we did see a bit of criticism of the government's COVID advertising campaign. Now we have this video of a real patient, or several of them in ICU, released by a major hospital. Do you think this will make people take notice?
Well, yeah, I think so. But I also think people are already concerned about this. There's already a lot of fear in the community. So we have to get the balance right. I was quite concerned about some of the advertising that went around Sydney. We need to get the messages out. We need to bring the community on board with everything that we're doing. I think people already understand that vaccination is important and that needs to be promoted. But there's a whole science around health promotion, and we need to use that to get the messages right.
Yeah, more scientists telling us about the actual messages, isn't it? And sending people to their GP for the information. Thank you very much for your time.
My pleasure.